By studying cell biology of corals, we can specifically look at the cells that are involved in, for example, making the skeleton, or the cells that have their symbiotic algae living within their tissues. My name is Martin Tresguerres, and I'm an associate professor in marine biology at the Scripps Institution of Oceanography, UC San Diego. Here in my lab, we study mostly the molecular and cell biology of marine organisms, and that requires specific and specialized tools. So the tools that we use are mostly adapted from biomedical sciences. Something unusual about my lab is that we work from molecules to cells to animals to also trying to extend that to field studies. So one of the most exciting projects that I have in the lab in the moment is collaborating with coral reef ecologists here at Scripps. And one of the things we do in the field is we scuba dive for the different corals from different sites, different depths that experience different conditions in terms of temperature, pH, and light. And then we take those to the lab to analyze their cell biology. We also do what is known as transplant experiments. So we collect corals from one site with certain conditions and take them to another site in which they have different conditions, and we leave them there for a year to see if they can adapt to the new conditions. So these are very exciting times to study cell biology and physiology of marine organisms, because thanks to these new technologies such as bioinformatics, microscopy, and other molecular techniques, we are learning things about organisms that we could not even imagine a few years ago. And this is one of my favorite things about science, how it doesn't matter how long you work on something, there's always something new to discover.